Hey guys, this is Leo from Generate Press and Generate Blocks. In this video, I'm going to show you how to replicate the module section of the GP Premium page using Generate Blocks. So that's this section here. The section is currently custom coded with HTML and CSS, as GB doesn't exist at the time when we built the page. However, it can now be replicated quite easily with the help of the Gutenberg editor and GB. Let's get started. First, we will make sure that we have Generate Blocks plugin installed and activated. Then we can go ahead and create a new page. Let's just call it Replicate GP Modules Layout. We will set the content container of GP to full width. This will allow us to have full control using GB. Let's create the two headlines here. We can add our first headline block. You can choose which heading you want to use, or paragraph, or simply a div. I'm going to go with the default H2 here. The headline block allows you to have all these options. So let's change the font weight to a little bit narrower. And we'll go with text line center, size 35 pixel is fine. Let's add a second headline block. This time we'll use just a paragraph. Text line center, and everything else is fine. Now let's create the grid section right here. We will start by adding a container block. The outer container will be full width, the inner container will be contained, and let's decrease the container width by a little bit. You have all the other options here. I'm going to leave the padding as default, 40 pixel all around right now. Inside the container block, we will add a grid block. You can choose any of these, but I'm going to start with just a full grid. I'm going to click the container inside the grid and set it to 33%. Inside our container, we will start with an image block. Select the image from the media library and set the alignment to center. The next section we have is this headline right here. So we will add a headline block. We will go with heading 3, text align center, increase the font weight to 600. Next, we have this description right here. This should just be a paragraph. Text align center. And we will use the left right padding to make the text a little bit narrower. Let's go with a little more. The next element we have is a button, which we will add a buttons block. In order to align the button, we have to select the buttons container, not just the button itself. Now we can go back and edit the button. We will go with white for background color and black for text color. Let's add some border. And some border radius. Decrease the top and bottom padding a little. Lastly, let's change the hover background color. We will go with a light blue. So at this point, we are basically done with one module. Right now, the desktop layout is set to 33%. On tablet, it's also set to 33, but I want it a little bit wider. So let's go with 50% on tablet. Then on mobile, it's default to 100, and that looks good. The easiest way to replicate this container for the rest of the modules here is to make sure we have the container selected and just click the plus sign here. The last thing I want to adjust is the space between each of the container here. We can do so by selecting the grid wrapper. And add some vertical gap. Let's hide the site title and take a look at the result. I hope you find this video helpful. Thanks for watching.